little meadow
mm-hmm.
where I have a ranger cabin
uh-huh.
and I have a larger Scandinavian style house.
Wow, you have lots of houses. Zephyr, what's that?
Oh. Morning, YouTube, friends and family. Hey, we're headed home. We're leaving Somerville. We had a great weekend with our relatives, and now a nice sunny ride home. Thanks for coming with me on my day. Thank you. You too.
Unload the car.
We're home. We've landed. It was a very uneventful trip. Very nice day to travel. I figured, you know, I really didn't have much to vlog about today. I really wasn't sort of in the vlogosphere, so to speak. So I figured it would be a great day for question and answer. I'm going to go back. I don't know how far. It looks like I'm starting back 3 weeks ago. It's been a long time since we've done a question and answer. I really enjoy them. I really enjoy your comments. I just have so little time right now in life in general that it's difficult for me to keep up. But I do read every single thing. Oh, here's one from the Colorado Trail. This is GSDFGS... GS... Who is this? GSDFGSHERTYERH? Anyway, he watched one of my Colorado Trail vlogs and asks, what month was it? It was quite likely in July. It was in July or August. Oh, okay, so this is day 8. This is after we've been in the woods for a week, and that was in July. That was when it was still, like, warm out in Colorado. Troy Blizzard did not like the Bigfoot and Sasquatch in a title for a contractor video. He said it's ridiculous, using it as a lure for someone to hit play the video. I think it's called clickbait. I think we are all guilty of using clickbait now and again. Kathy Miller asks, you know, I drive by this place near to here called Huzzy's General Store, and it has a sign outside that reads, wedding guns and cold beer. And she says, do they really sell wedding gowns? Yes, they do. They have a bridal department, they have a firearms department, and they have a whole beer department, besides a grocery store and a hardware store. So it's really quite a place. Some of these I don't even think I got to see. This is from my 300th vlog from Parthish D. But he's commenting from the year... did I make a misprint? From the year 3017. Wow, look at that bearded hairy man and the things that he did to survive. Oh, I did say that, didn't I? Awaiting the delivery of iTime, Time Machine, from Amazon Prime, so I was... will visit you on your 365th vlog with a lot of red wines. That's really funny, actually. Probably only to me. All inside jokes, right? Let's see. David Yu is asking, in the tracks in the snow were from the ducks, right? Actually, I think that was from the Chinese New Year vlog, and the tracks in the snow were likely from a wild animal. Did I find any missing eggs at their end? No, the ducks have not been laying eggs for quite some time. For I would say probably close to 2 months now. We've not been getting eggs. It's kind of been a bummer. They go through this period after they turn 1 year old called the molt, where they lose a lot of feathers. And after the molt, which takes several weeks to go by, apparently they start laying again, and even more than before. So I'm eagerly awaiting that time. And Caleb Stevens is a new Maine subscriber. Here's a shout out to Caleb for subscribing. He lives, I think, in, was it Western Maine? Yeah, Western Maine, that's right. Charm White, also on the Chinese New Year, asked if, you know, that we had made some egg rolls that evening and asked if Andre used a recipe for the veggie filling. She just wings it, you know. She's made egg rolls enough times now to just sort of know what goes inside, and they always come out so good. Access Films, I had a video entitled Ever See Groundhog Day, and Access Films asks, what does Curry record with? Access Films, I primarily, like 90% of the time, use my iPhone. About 10% of the time, or 8% of the time, I use my GoPro when I'm doing action, like, you know, where I need both hands. And then very once in a while, I have another action camera that I will use as well. So, but mostly the entire vlog occurs on this iPhone. You know, I do all the editing on iMovie. All of the songs are loaded onto the phone so I can, you know, put those. It all happens there. Let's see. Oh, Joe Tiziano asks about a bird in the hand when I sort of captured a bird in the loft of my barn. How long did the bird sit there? It was there just long enough for me to get that video out, Joe. And then basically I had to put the phone down because I couldn't open up the window with a bird in my hand to free it. So I put the phone down, opened up the window, and the bird flew away. And it sounds like, you know, about the time that we were having a big blizzard, New Zealand was having like record heat. You know, for them, 113 Fahrenheit, you know, to 45 degrees Celsius. That's huge. That's big. Poor Philip Reed. Xander Sales asks, Do you wish you have fame or keep the kind community that you have? You know, Xander, that's a wicked good question. I would love to keep you all forever and just take you along. And I would love, in order to do that, that I had a cameraman, like, videoing me. And then at the end of the day, having that same cameraman edit the video just like I would edit. You know, for me to keep doing this in perpetuity, it would have to be making money. The fame, I don't need. I don't know if they need to go hand in hand. I think that you can make money doing videos on YouTube without being famous, except maybe in your little genre. But, you know, I started monetizing in October. Since October, I have made about $150 with my videos, which really isn't a whole lot. It's kind of a drop in the bucket. It doesn't, you know, I don't do it to make the money. At least right now, I'm not doing it to make the money. I would, you know, the cool thing about being small is that I can have these interactions with you guys. You don't get lost in the sea. You know, I get to know you by your questions and by your comments and by your uploaded videos, which I watch as well. So I would like to have the best of both worlds, but it's really, I don't think I'm going to have the choice. For me to get famous or be able to make money at YouTube would require even more time than I'm putting into it right now. And I'd be crazy to devote more time to it than I am right now, unless I could directly get paid to do it. Okay. Oh, people like the mannequin shot. That was fun. My aunt, my aunt, who is Casey's mom, told me about the mannequin shot. I had never heard of it. I'd always wondered how they did those. Okay, Kathy Miller asks, love seeing your Mother's Day birthday party. Did she bake and decorate that beautiful cake? Kathy, yes. She's a food artist. She makes the most amazing cakes and cookies and confections and all kinds of beautiful things with the piping and the different frostings and always so tasty as well. She's an amazingly talented artist, and it goes from the canvas right down to the cooking, and baking. Yeah. Oh, and that was a comment that you said you should do another Q&A for us soon, Kathy. Well, here it is. Did the ducks get out of their cage? Oh, you know, 911 Lex Vegas asks, you know, during my video titled Snowmageddon, when we had the 2 feet of snow, did they get... That day, Lex Vegas, 911 Lex Vegas, they did not leave their coop at all. In fact, there was a series of about 5 or 6 days where they did not leave the barn. They didn't even leave. We would open up the barn door and they wouldn't leave because it was just so much snow. They would have been like penguins, you know? Okay, the Crazy Family Show was watching me do some plowing and asks, is the plow one that you made yourself? No, it's not, but it sure looks like it, doesn't it? It's definitely seen some abuse. Oh, you know, John Legg wanted to know how the dinner mystery dinner theater went. We had an awesome time at that. I didn't really get to tell you all about that after we went. It was a unique experience that I've never had before that I want to do again. And now that I know what they're all about, I think I can have a better, more deep time. But, you know, basically, there was a troupe of actors, and they acted out a murder mystery, right? And they were all mic'd up, and there was speakers everywhere. So every once in a while, you would hear conversations between these actors that were mic'd up, and they might be over in that corner of the room, or they might be over in the bar, or they might be off scene. And you were each given a set of clues and a card with some information, and you could choose to share it with other people, or you could hold it yourself. And the idea was to pay attention, to have a five-course meal, to enjoy drinks at the bar, and to try to figure out what the dynamic was between these dozen actors and ultimately who killed. There ended up being three murders. And I gotta say, it was so engaging and interesting, but so complex that we had absolutely no idea who had done the murders. So I definitely wanna do it again. The first time, don't be surprised if you don't get it, but I think once you understand how the mechanism works, then it could really be a lot more fun. Oh, Beth Richmond, your husband is a loser on Valentine's Day too? Oh man, I'm such a loser. She did not say loser. I used that word. She just said I'm not the only man that sucks at Valentine's Day. Everett C. asks, you know that place in Yarmouth that I just finished up the job, what are they going to use that space for? Everett, that's going to be a kid's giant playroom. And on one end, there's going to be a storage room. And another person asks, how the heck are they going to get in there? Like, the day that I was cleaning up and leaving that job, my father was going to cutting a hole through the floor, which has a stairwell there built and all ready to be cut through, and connect the two spaces. So it'll be, you know, there'll be a stairwell down into the entryway, which connects to the house. You guys are paying attention, though, with these questions, I can tell. Raymond Mills asks, are me and the missus ready for Milo to be driving? I would say yes and no. Yes, because now he can cart his own butt around to all these crazy things, and he can even, like, help out with the twins doing stuff. No, because of all the reasons you might imagine. You know, I get nervous about... Although Maine has some pretty strict rules about who you can drive with, you know. If he's driving one of our cars, he cannot have passengers. Unless they're siblings. I think until you're... I don't know if that's your first year or until you're 18 or something. So that makes me a lot... more confident about what will happen, but I'm mainly just nervous about the other people. You know, I think he'll be a good driver. I have concerns like, you know, how are we going to share cars? The insurance cost is going to go up. You know, there's just all that stuff, but I'm ready for him. You know, we live in rural Maine, man. You know, to do anything, you've got to drive. So he really deserves to have his license so he can start doing his own stuff, you know? Rob Bobcat says it's nice to see the kids playing outdoors in the snow. I totally agree, Rob. Rob Bobcat, not Bob Robcat. Sometimes we have to prod them. Sometimes we have to poke, sometimes we have to goad them. But generally speaking, once they're out there, they have a blast. And it always helps if I go out with them, you know? And I have fun too. Oh, no way. YouTube has inserted a toilet paper advertisement at the start of my video where I'm using cellulose. That is so funny. Okay, well, you know, I'm going to end it with this one. It might not be a super positive note, but there was one that I thought about a lot when it came through. Is from 911 Lex Vegas. You know, he said two things. One, health insurance is a mess because Obama threw a wrench in the best healthcare system in the world. Which I don't know what that system was that he threw a wrench into. I didn't know that we had one before that. And then he says, hey, buddy, the government isn't there to buy you insurance. Stop relying on government to take care of you. Government should be about police, fire department, EMS, military, roads, maybe garbage pickup. The less government you have, the better. You know, I understand that's the typical sort of Republican conservative platform. I would want to be clear to say, though, that the government is not buying me health insurance and never has. Up until very recently, we went on the Obamacare, as it's called, and we got a tax credit that helped us pay for it. But, you know, basically, I pay about $600 a month for one kind of healthcare through the exchange, and then another $50 for another, and the government... pays roughly $500 to add to make a $1,200 a month payment to the insurance company. So I'm definitely still paying for my insurance and paying quite dearly, according to me. I mean, $600 a month for me is a lot of money. And to maintain that on a single income has been challenging. You know, government, it should be about police, which is what protecting, upholding the law, right? I totally understand that. The fire department, yeah, for, you know, saving our buildings. The EMS for saving us when we're you know, in danger of death. But after that, you're on your own, I guess. The military, right? You know, in case there's bad guys that are going to try and attack. Roads, maybe. I get it, you know, but I'm just on a different page, which is I think that if we could come up with a system where everybody could have health care regardless of your income level, and not have the overwhelming debt or illness that comes with not being able to afford healthcare, then overall as a society, I think we'd be better. I think that's the major difference between sort of, you know, the progressives and the conservatives is that, you know, the belief in society working together to make it better for everybody. And that's sort of where I'm coming from. And that takes money. There's no doubt about it. And in order to get money, you got to raise taxes, and you got to raise a lot of taxes. So I can understand from a conservative standpoint where that would be like crazy to contemplate. So, you know, it's a problem that we're not solved. It was definitely not solved. I'll be interested to see how it all plays out. In the meantime, I just keep paying, you know, and I don't even have dental care at this point. We don't have dental insurance anymore because I can't afford it. You know, so anyway, I can on that. I can just go one more here. Okay, MSW Dev, how do you get the ducks to go back in the cage? You know, MSW Dev, at the end of the day, when it starts to get dark, they just walk up there themselves. In the summertime, it's a little different. They'll linger around. The kids, all they really have to do is walk outside, start walking towards the ducks and making some noise, and the ducks will just head on back to their coop for the night without any, without any delay. They just go, man. All right, hey, thanks for joining me for this question and answer. It's almost gotten dark since I've been doing this, so I know I've been doing it for a while. I gotta take off now and take Milo to driver's ed. Thanks for coming with me on my weekend. And we'll see you in the car. Thank you.